China making its presence felt as the Philippines and the U.S. hold their joint military drills. The Philippine Navy says the number of Chinese vessels swarming the West Philippine Sea surged to over 100 last week. It expects China's shadowing activities to continue along with the Balikatan exercises.
It's only for this week that we have seen a surge of up to a total of 124. This particular increase is not normal. On the reason why, I can only say it coincides with Balikatan.
Navy also clarifies the use of a China-made ship as target for the military exercises is just coincidental.
It's just coincidental. It's not complicated, it's coincidental. No pun intended, no meaning to that. It's just coincidental.
Just like in any sinking exercise around the world, they use all vessels as the target of the exercise. And the same thing we are doing with Lake Caliraya.
At least 16,000 troops from the Philippines, the U.S. and France joined this year's military drills, which will run until May 10. Philippine lawmaker Joseph Lara defending his proposal to conduct an inquiry into the alleged influx of Chinese students in Cagayan Province. He says his proposal does not reek of xenophobia and racism. He insists the probe is needed and the concerns are valid given the growing tensions between Manila and Beijing in the West Philippine Sea.
Ang fear lang automatic na ako pa mismo. Eh kung hindi naman legit na student, siyempre worrisome na 'yon. 'Di ba? Anong purpose pumunta doon? So, 'yun yung kaagad na fear din namin. So, kung anong intention talaga. Katulad po ng mga naririnig ko na rin na commentaries ngayon na may mga sleeper cells, alam niyo naman 'yan more than sa akin, no? Eh talagang sabi ko nga sa amin mismo nakakabahala na. Kasi kami mismo ang nandun sa lugar. I will be the last person po na magsasabi niyan na anti-Chinese. Kasi para lang malaman nyo din, my wife is of Chinese descent din. No? Formerly, yung lola niya is Chinese. So hindi ko po masasabi yan. Nagkataon po na Chinese lang ang mga estudyante doon. At sa tingin namin, yung 400 plus, kahit ngayon, mukhang unusual naman talaga.
Marami pa rin.
Marami pa rin.
The Bureau of Immigration earlier said around 1,500 Chinese nationals received student visas from the agency last year. Extrajudicial killings remain a serious problem in the Philippines. That's according to a U.S. State Department report, which showed in 2023, the killings were largely carried out by police and other security forces. It notes impunity was a significant problem, particularly in the Philippine National Police. Among the killings highlighted in the report, the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Digamo in last March last year and the death of 17-year-old Jember Baltazar at the hands of Navotas police. The report cites data from the University of the Philippines, Dahas PH, which recorded over 200 killings in anti-drug operations from January to August last year. It adds the Philippine Human Rights Commission also investigated 51 new complaints of alleged EJ case or politically motivated killings in 2023.
Standing up for freedom and human rights is simply the right thing to do. But defending and promoting these inalienable and universal rights is also profoundly in our national interest. Countries that respect human rights are more likely to be peaceful, prosperous, stable.
The U.S. State Department also notes while the number of EJ cases in the Philippines decreased in 2023, there were no significant changes in the human rights situation in the country. The Presidential Communications Office warns the public against a circulating audio deepfake of President Marcos. The manipulated video featured a supposed audio of Marcos instructing the military to act against a foreign country. But the PCO says such a directive does not exist, adding the agency is actively working on measures to combat misinformation and disinformation. The PCO also says it is closely working with relevant agencies agencies and other stakeholders to address the proliferation of malicious deepfakes. It also calls on Filipinos to be more discerning of the content they see online. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. rejecting calls to strip Vice President Sara Duterte of her cabinet position over her alleged feud with the First Lady. Joyce Balancho reports.
Vice President Sara Duterte is not going anywhere amid calls from various lawmakers for her resignation or replacement as Education Secretary. No less than President Marcos is backing the Vice President, saying he has no reason to remove Duterte from her post.
Any of the cabinet secretaries will be replaced pag hindi nila ginagawa yung trabaho nila. Di talaga marunong o korap, di ba? Tatanggalin ka talaga namin. Eh, hindi naman ganun sinday eh.
This comes as First Lady Liza Marcos admitted she was hurt when the Vice President laughed when President Marcos was accused of being a drug addict during a recent rally in Davao City. The remarks were made by former President Rodrigo Duterte.
It will not affect our working relationship with the Vice President, Secretary of Education. Huwag niyang masyadong dibdibin at hindi naman siyang na mga nagsabi tungkol sa kung ano-ano. Madali naman sigurong plansahin lahat itong issue.
The chief executive says he will speak with the Vice President on matters concerning his wife.
I don't think we need to patch anything up. I think she understands, as I said, as a wife herself, she understands the sentiments of the First Lady. And our conversation will be precisely that. I am sure you understand how she feels.
The president argues his wife isn't used to mudslinging, but he feels lucky to have a wife who defends him from critics.
First of all, my first reaction is what a lucky husband I am, that I have a wife na very protective sa akin na kahit na may nakita ang hindi magandang sinabi tungkol sa akin, she gets very upset. I guess we cannot blame her. Ang First Lady, hindi sanay sa politika yan eh. Kami manhid na kami dyan sa mga insulto. Siya, hindi siya galing sa political family. Kaya siguro she still has to learn na magpalampas ng konti ng mga ibang masasakit at may init at banghang sa salita.
Vice President Duterte, for her part, maintains the sentiments of the First Lady do not affect her mandate as a public official. She also insisted that government should instead focus its attention to the problems and challenges that the country is facing. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
No near end in sight to power woes in the Philippines. The country's grid operator once again issued red and yellow alerts in Luzon and Visayas Tuesday due to multiple shutdowns of power plants. The Energy Department and power provider Meralco now appealing to big businesses that consume more electricity to dechain from Meralco and use their own generators to minimize demand pressure from the utility. But for a former energy secretary, government needs to do more to address the ongoing power crisis. Leyte Governor Jericho Padilla says government should construct a 500 to 1,000 megawatt power plant specifically designed for critical times when power supply is insufficient.
PNOC can come up with a plan. Pero para walang lituhan dito, okay, wala nang debate dito kasi merong iba nagsasabi, dapat hindi ang gobyerno pumasok. Gumawa ng batas. Konti lang ang nag-online na planta during the past administration. Ang susunod na administration, susunod kay Presidente BBM, ang solusyon niya sa power is now. Will have to be done now. It will have to be planned now. Hindi pag-upo ng susunod na presidente, doon palang ayusin.
Senator Riza Ontiveros also slams the DOE for passing the burden of reducing power demand to the public. She says the government should deliver lasting solutions to the country's power woes.